problem asks about primes, which are factors of n to the 6 minus 1. As a result of that, I think it's a good idea to start by factorising n to the 6 minus 1 to understand more about what primes might divide it. If we try to do that, the first thing we notice is that this is a difference of two squares, because n to the 6 is the square of n cubed. So we can write this as n cubed plus 1 times n cubed minus 1. Now, it turns out that each of these two terms can itself be factorised. These may perhaps be factorisations you already know, but if not, that's no problem, you can do it by hand. One way to do it by hand is to notice that this first term has a root at minus 1, and that means it's got a factor of n plus 1, and you can check by long division or something that the other factor is then n squared minus n plus 1. Then this factor similarly has a root at 1, which means it has a factor of n minus 1. Then by long division again, the other factor is going to be n squared plus n plus 1. So that's the factorisation. So if we've got a prime that's a factor of n to the 6 minus 1, then it's going to be a factor of one of these four different factors itself. We're going to go on and classify primes dividing n to the 6 minus 1 by which of the four terms they divide. But first, it's going to be pleasant to go and do a couple of small cases first. The reason is that I don't want to interrupt later by dealing with small cases, so I'll just deal with 2 and 3 now. So what happens if p is 2? Well, we're asking about 2 dividing n to the 6 minus 1, so we're asking when is n to the 6 minus 1 even? And the answer is n to the 6 minus 1 is even if n is odd. So the smallest n bigger than 1 for which p divides n to the 6 minus 1 is n is 3. But then 5 is also odd. So 2 satisfies the problem. 3 is the minimal n, but then 3 plus 2 also works. What happens if p is 3? Well, this is a bit scarier, but the numbers haven't gotten too big yet, so we can do it by hand. Turns out that if n is 2, this is 2 to the 6 minus 1. 2 to the 6 is 64, so 2 to the 6 minus 1 is 63, which is 21 times 3. So n is 2 is the minimal n bigger than 1 for which p divides n to the 6 minus 1. However, then, if we look at 4 to the 6 minus 1, that's equal to 2 to the 6 plus 1 times 2 to the 6 minus 1. And so 3 divides 4 to the 6 minus 1 because it also divides 2 to the 6 minus 1. And therefore, n is 2 plus 2 also works. So p is 3 works for the problem as well. Now from here, I'm going to go on and do, as I promised, the four factors in turn. So what if p divides n to the 6 minus 1 because it divides n plus 1? Well, if p divides n plus 1, then p also divides n plus 2 minus 1. Because that's the same thing. But that means if we've got a prime that divides this factor, then it'll divide this factor for n plus 2. So in this case, we're fine. If p divides n to the 6 minus 1 because it divides this factor, then it'll divide n plus 2 to the 6 minus 1 because it will divide that factor for that number. What if p divides n to the 6 minus 1 because it divides this factor? Well, there's an identity that's going to help us here. So n squared minus n plus 1 is equal to n minus 1 squared plus n minus 1 plus 1. Why does that help us? Well, the question only asks us to think about the minimal n for which p divides n to the 6 minus 1. But if p divides n to the 6 minus 1 because it divides this factor, then it would have divided this factor for n minus 1. So we don't actually have to worry about this case because it can't correspond to the minimal n. Now we ask, what happens if p divides this factor here? And if p divides n minus 1, then p divides n minus 2 plus 1, because that's the same thing. So again, this is going to give us a contradiction of minimality. So if we assume that n is the smallest n greater than 1 for which p divides n minus 2 plus 1, it can't be the case that p divides n minus 1 because it would have divided this factor for n minus 2 already. And here's one of the cases where we see that dealing with the small cases earlier so that we can talk about what happens when n minus 2 was a good thing to do. And lastly, we ask, what if p divides n to the 6 minus 1 because it divides this factor here? Well, n squared plus n plus 1 turns out to be equal to n plus 1 squared minus n plus 1 plus 1. So that means if p divides n squared plus n plus 1, then it also divides this factor, but for n plus 1. That's okay. As the question asks, what we want is for it to work for n plus 1 or n plus 2, and we've done that. And in fact, we've done it in all four cases. In all four cases, either it can't be the minimal n, or n plus 1 or n plus 2 also work. So we're done.